Hello, my name is Ron Bonica. I'm a distinguished engineer from Juniper Networks, and today we're here to talk about segment routing. So, what is segment routing? Segment routing is a mechanism that a source node can use to put a packet on an SR path that will bring it from its ingress to its egress. Now, what's an SR path? An SR path provides unidirectional connectivity from ingress to egress. That SR path can follow the least cost path from ingress to egress, or it might follow a path that isn't the least cost path, but it avoids something that you want to avoid, like a point of congestion. There are two approaches to traffic engineering, a traditional approach and the segment routing approach. In the traditional approach, the ingress node puts exactly one label on each packet. That label represents the entire path from ingress to egress. Every transit node along the path needs to maintain per path information. How is segment routing different? In segment routing, we divide that path into segments. Each segment ends in a segment endpoint. You can think of it as being a waypoint. So, the SR ingress node puts many labels on a packet. Each label represents a segment. It sends the packet to the first segment egress node. The first segment egress node looks at the outermost label and processes it. And it also pops the outermost label off and sends it on to the second egress node. It looks at the outermost label and processes it. Pops that label off and sends it to the next, until finally the packet arrives at the egress node with no labels whatsoever. To explain the difference between traditional approaches to traffic engineering and segment routing, we're going to use an analogy. And in this analogy, we're going to go back to my childhood, maybe first, second grade, a time when I really didn't know the way home from school yet, and neither did any of my classmates. So the teacher came up with a clever solution. She put a baseball cap on each of us, and the baseball cap had our name on it. She also told the crossing guards where each kid lived and how to get each kid home. So when I left school and got to the first intersection, the crossing guard turned me left. At the next intersection, the crossing guard turned me right. And sooner or later, I arrived at home. This worked well, except for two problems. The first problem is that the crossing guards needed to maintain quite a lot of information. They needed to know where each kid lived and how to get them home. What's more, when things changed, the crossing guards needed to learn new information. For instance, when a new kid showed up at school, all the crossing guards needed to learn where he lived. If there was construction a few blocks down the street, all of the crossing guards needed to learn new routes. Since this wasn't working very well, the teacher came up with another solution. Rather than putting one cap on each kid at the end of the day, she'd put many caps on each kid. Each cap had an instruction: turn left, turn right, proceed straight without turning. When a kid arrives at an intersection, the crossing guard takes a look at the instruction on the outermost hat and executes the instruction. If the baseball cap said turn left, the crossing guard turns the kid left, takes the top hat away, and sends the kid on his way. The next crossing guard looks at the instruction at the top of the stack of hats, takes that hat away, turns the kid in the right direction, and sends the kid on his way. At the end of the afternoon, every kid arrives at home hatless. So let's summarize the differences between traditional approaches to traffic engineering and the segment routing approach. In the traditional approach, we put a single label on each packet, and that label represents the entire path from segment ingress to segment egress. Every transit node needs to maintain per path information. In the segment routing approach, we put many labels on each packet. Each label represents a segment. Transit nodes only need to maintain information regarding the segments in which they participate. One of the benefits of this is that the transit nodes no longer need to run protocols to distribute per path information. Thank you for watching, and for more information, check out our website at juniper.net/SR.